Lightrix has released a new model with 13 billion parameters, which requires more resources to run than the older 2 billion parameter model. However, there is also a quantized version of the 13 billion parameter model that should work on graphics cards with lower memory. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up the workflow in Comfy UI. To begin, I first needed to update Comfy UI by running the update stable file, and mine is already up to date. I will start Comfy UI. And since this basic workflow is not required, I will create a new workflow here. You can see that the version I am using is 0.3.34. Inside the Comfy UI Manager, these are the installed nodes. I think these nodes are not necessary, as it comes from previous videos. The GGUF node will be needed because I am creating this video for users with smaller graphic cards, and I will be using GGUF models. The LTX workflow requires some custom nodes from Lightrix. I will search for Comfy UI LTX, and this is what I am looking for. I will share the link in the description. Scroll down if you're interested in finding the latest topics. This looks new. They have released distilled models with 13 billion parameters today. However, this video will focus on the models released below. Here is the original model, and this section discusses the quantized models. This is the quantized FP8 model by Lightrix, but it is still larger for 6 or 8 gigabyte cards. Additionally, you need to have the MS Toolkit, which increases the complexity of the setup. They have also released two upscaling models to enhance the generated video. These upscaling models could be a topic for the next video. Right now, we are on the repository required to run LTX inside Comfy UI. But to keep it simple and ensure compatibility with smaller cards, I need different LTX models. I suggest searching for LTX GGUF. You should find a result at the top. This is the older 2 billion parameter model, so make sure you do not get confused. I will search for the 13 billion GGUF models. This is the one I will be using. Click on Files and Versions. Starting from Q3 to Q8, these are the quantized models. The lower the number, the smaller the model, which is better for smaller graphics cards. The Q3 model should work on a 6 gigabytes card. It may be slower than using an 8 gigabytes card, but it should still function. To have LTX work in Comfy UI, we need to place this repository in the Custom Nodes folder. First, copy the link. Next, go to the Comfy UI project, navigate to the Custom Nodes directory, and clone the project there. Make sure you have Git installed. Open the command prompt in the same directory, type git clone, paste the copied link, and then press enter. Now I have the LTX nodes, which are required to run LTX inside Comfy UI. You will also need the GGUF nodes, which can be installed using the Comfy UI Manager. If you do not have them, search for GGUF in the search box and install the nightly version. I don't anticipate using any other nodes, so I will restart the application. I remember that since I will be generating videos, I need the video helper from Comfy UI to save the video. This video helper suite is required. Install it and restart to avoid any problems. I will name this workflow and then search for the nodes. As I explained in my earlier videos, start with a node that has the most connections. The base sampler is where everything happens. The first connection here is for the model. I will be using GGUF, so I will search for it. The model I showed you is a UNet, not a checkpoint. I hope you remember that I explained the difference in the previous video. A checkpoint includes UNet, clip text encoder, and VAE, all in a single safe tensor file. Right now, I need to load the clip from a separate file, and then the VAE. Select the UNet, and make sure not to get confused with the 2 billion models. I will be using this Q4 model, which I downloaded from here. I will also try this Q6 model and save it inside the models folder and then the UNet folder. With the Q6 model, I also took the clip text encoder, this T5Q6 file, and save it inside the clip folder. The link for text encoder will be in the description. I will select the Q4 clip text encoder and the respective UNet file. The type here will be LTXV. Now I need the VAE file. This README file contains some information. It states that you can keep the model inside the diffusion model folder. It also works from the UNet folder. Below is the text encoder, and this is where I got the GGUF text encoder. The reason I am sharing all this is so you can learn how to find useful resources instead of just picking files from the video description. You can get the VAE from here. This is the file. It mentions BF16, so I'm not sure if it will work on cards older than the 3000 series. If someone can comment on this, it would be great. Connect the model and the VAE. This clip will be connected, but there will be a node for the prompt in between, eventually leading into the guider. This recommendation does not show the node I am looking for. Search for STG guider. This advanced guider should work. The prompt we type, with the help of clip models, guides the video generation process. These nodes will assist in guiding the video generation process. Below is the sampler, which was easy to set up. Then we have the sigmas for sampler and schedule types. Next is the random noise, similar to the empty latent image we use for image generation. This is an optional requirement. It takes an image, and then this will be an image-to-video generating workflow. The image is from an older video, which I will remove for now. I will try text-to-video generation first. I will make some space here for the positive and negative prompt notes. The prompt passes through the conditioning node to the guider. This preset is optional, but why leave it empty if I've cloned the LTX repository? I hope the workflow makes sense to you. I have completed the connections on the left side. On the right, there is an output that needs to be decoded. I hope you saw the previous video where I discussed encoding and decoding. This diffusion model operates in latent space. The VAE passes through the LTX node for decoding, and we obtain multiple frames as output. These frames are then combined and saved in a video format. I have finished the workflow for generating text to video. If I connect the image node, it will become an image to video workflow. There are some settings to adjust here for the best results. Like this number of steps, which refers to the video generation steps. The higher the number, the more refined and clean the video will be. Values between 25 and 30 are optimal. The noise seed can be a random number, serving as an empty canvas to begin the video generation process. However, according to the recommended workflow on Hugging Face, a fixed number, 109, is suggested for this value. The height and width of the video can be set here, and this total number of frames also determines the length of the video. Using these 97 frames, I can create a video at a rate of 8 frames per second. However, I should increase this to 24 frames per second to achieve a smoother video. Therefore, 97 frames will result in a 4-second video at 24 frames per second. When I attempt to generate the video, it indicates that the prompt is required, and I realize I missed something in the connection. Now, this should work with an appropriate prompt. I obtained a prompt from the internet. You can get a prompt from AI services like GPT by requesting a 5-line prompt on a specific topic. I will also include a negative prompt. The prompt I am using is about river flow and trees, while a negative prompt I selected is based on an image, and it should work. I will cue the workflow. The process is utilizing almost the entire VRAM, but I believe it should also function on low VRAM cards. Each step takes around 15 seconds, and I have set the workflow to 30 steps. After 409 seconds, which is 6 minutes and 49 seconds, the result is a 4-second video with 24 frames per second. Not an interesting video. Let me look into settings. Make sure to select a video format from here, or else the file saved in the output directory will be an image. I will type the prefix here. File name saved in the output directory will begin with this prefix. The video I am getting is not good, so I started to try different settings. I tried keeping 24 frames here and changed the preset to dynamic. I started doing all sorts of changes and tried generating videos. This looked kind of okay. After some more changes, I got this result. A blonde woman in a movie scene. I tried increasing the video length by increasing the total frames. If the video generated is of 24 frames a second, then 120 frames should give me a 5-second video, and 240 will give me a 10-second video. It takes one extra frame whatever I type the number of frames here. I queued the prompt. After 1,000 seconds, I got this result. It's fine, but nothing much is happening in the video. I selected the Q6 model and the clip text encoder. I tried again with a random prompt from the internet. After 1,100 seconds, I got this result. The prompt was about a cityscape, tall building, circular building in the center, and camera moving from left to right. The video looks fine, but it was kind of unrealistic. Tried again with keywords like realistic, and the video was good, but kind of a 3D game. Made a few more changes in the settings and gave a prompt for a movie scene where two police officers are entering through a door. The result looks good. You can pause and have the settings as per on the screen. I will be sharing the workflow after a few more videos. A 10-second video takes around 1,000 seconds on my 4060 Ti 16GB card, and the results are good, though it has some deformity. You can try a couple of times and pick the best one. This video reminds me of SDXL models. It was common for images generated by those models to have disfigured faces when the subject was far from the camera. A guy speaking on an old telephone, holding a drink in his hand. A clip from an old movie. The lamp behind shows this is AI generated. What else can you spot? The earpiece in his hand is broken. It's not perfect, but also not bad. A woman in pink hair screaming, arguing, an old movie scene. I did not specify facial expressions like anger. She is screaming with no expression. Well, maybe you can try the facial expressions. After trying multiple examples, I have noticed most of the characters are having problems with their eyes. For an image to video generation, I took an image from Civit AI and connected the image node with the optional parameter conImage. The prompt is the same as it was for the image. Make sure this crop is set to center. It will crop and adjust the video accordingly. The challenge here is I have given a long portrait image and the size specified for video generation is wide. Also, do not keep this value empty. Keep it zero, or else the image given may not work. From a portrait image to landscape video, this looks fine. In the prompt, I specified a blurry background, but the video is having a blurry transition. You need to play around with a prompt to understand the way it works. This portrait video turned out to be a good one. I really like the way the camera goes around and it gets blurred and then the wheel starts rolling. This model may generate bad results sometimes, but I have made it worse than this using stable video diffusion. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Hope this video was helpful.